Welcome to this third episode of this Making Of series, in which I discuss how to create the images and videos I make. And today we're going to talk about how to choose your AI image generator. So there are more and more generators these days. People also create them for specific uses, and they make add-ons that alter the original capabilities of them. But as a general rule, if you have to keep something in mind, there are mostly three big players. There's Stable Diffusion, there's Midjourney, and there's DALL-E 3. Each of them have their own versions. So I started creating images with Stable Diffusion about 1 year ago, I think. And back then I was using version 1.5. Then they launched version 2.0 and 2.1, which were not that great. And now it's using Stable Diffusion XL, which is the most recent and best one. Midjourney, I think, is on version 6, and DALL-E 3 belongs to the same company that owns ChatGPT, OpenAI, and is currently on its third iteration, so DALL-E 3. The greatest difference between these three is between Stable Diffusion and Midjourney or DALL-E 3. Stable Diffusion is open source and you can run it on your own machine, whereas Midjourney and DALL-E 3 are cloud-based programs. So you pay for them, and you can also access them on the internet. This has pros and cons. The greatest pro of running something on your own machine is the customizability. With Stable Diffusion XL, for example, it can be customized to do whatever you want. Since the program is running on your machine, you have so many details you can tweak and alter on how it works. There are so many add-ons and plugins and things like LoRAs and specific interfaces. You can use different interfaces. For example, you can run Stable Diffusion using Automatic 1111 as an interface or using ConfUI as an interface. There are so many different possibilities. It's a whole world in it. And so, if you try to compare what you can ultimately do with Stable Diffusion or with Midjourney and DALL-E 3, Stable Diffusion will easily win because it doesn't have, for example, censorship filters. So if you want to create an image of a vulva or of a penis for academic purposes because you are a urologist or a gynecologist and you want to teach about it, you can create it with Stable Diffusion. You can't create it with Midjourney or DALL-E 3 because they're a blocker prompt, because it violates their safety content policy or something like this. So, in terms of what you can do, Stable Diffusion wins easily. It has way more capabilities. However, when we talk, for example, about the requirements of Stable Diffusion, both in hardware and in skill, are much greater than Midjourney and DALL-E. DALL-E and Midjourney are relatively easy. DALL-E 3 is the easiest of all of them. You basically need no prior knowledge. You just go into their website, perhaps you go into Bing and ask Bing, create an image of a sheep shaped like a liver, and it will create an image of a sheep shaped like a liver for you. The greatest pro is its accessibility. Anyone can easily get into it, no prior knowledge required, easy, fast. Midjourney is a bit more complex. You have to register, you have to know a bit about how Discord works, but it's still mostly easy. Stable Diffusion will require some learning. I personally learned Stable Diffusion watching YouTube videos. You are watching a YouTube video right now, so I think you also like to learn using YouTube videos, but you probably have some learning skill. It's unlikely you start creating great Stable Diffusion images after 2 days playing with it. It would most likely take a few weeks or months for you to get the gist of it. Also, you need to have a powerful computer. For example, if you don't have a video card with at least like 8 GB of VRAM, then you're probably going to run into some trouble. And I'm just talking about the basic images. We're not talking, for example, about generating video. That's a whole different kind of works. But Stable Diffusion, very customizable, very powerful, requires an extensive and well-built computer, harder to learn, no filter of censorship, and also free. Midjourney is paid, DALL-E 3 can be free or paid. If you access DALL-E 3 through Bing, it's free. If you access it through ChatGPT 4, then it costs, or at least it uses to cost, $10 a month. And regarding image quality, I would say that overall they all get good results. Sable Diffusion 1.5 was definitely worse than Midjourney or DALL-E 3. However, Stable Diffusion XL is pretty comparable to the other two. So nowadays, if you know what you're doing, you can get pretty much the same results, or rather different but comparable results, with these three tools. Advantages: Stable Diffusion and DALL-E 3 are free. Midjourney and DALL-E 3 require few experience or skill, and Stable Diffusion is more powerful and more flexible. Usually, nowadays, I mostly use DALL-E 3 because it's so easy and fast. And if I need, for example, to do some finer detail to inpaint something, or when I upscale using Latent Diffusion Super Resolution, LDSR, then I use Stable Diffusion. Stable Diffusion is also the only one that can do image to image, which can be really important if you have something very specific in mind. If you're not doing it for the art, but rather, for example, you want to create an image of yourself in some kind of anatomical context, then Stable Diffusion is most likely your best option. I don't use Midjourney because it's paid and not as flexible as Stable Diffusion. However, development is pretty fast-paced between these competitors, so you want to keep an eye on them, because sometimes they will release a new version, then everything could change. But as a general rule, keep in mind that usually when you speak about AI art or AI images in a general way, quantity is king. The more results you produce, the more likely you get at least one good one. So rather than trying to get the perfect prompt the very first time, just experiment it with. Create hundreds of images and then choose the best one. Look for inspiration, get your clear vision, and then try to replicate it. So if you visit somewhere interesting, for example, try to think, or if you see something on the TV or on a movie, try to think how could that apply to your area of expertise, to your knowledge, for example, to anatomy. Then create in your mind a clear vision of what you're thinking about, and then try to convert the image you've created towards your vision. Third and lastly, people tend to like more what's beautiful than what's novel. I've learned this somewhat the hard way with Instagram, but sometimes you get a brilliant idea. Oh, I can't believe I had such a fantastic idea. What if I represent it as this and it has a whole new meaning behind it, and it will get 600 likes. And then you create a simple image that's just pretty because you had to post something, and it will get 4,000 likes. So make sure your images are visually appealing. No matter your purpose, whether you're teaching, whether you're doing it for the art, you need to catch people's attention, either your audience or your students. Make sure they look beautiful. And don't forget, this video is sponsored by myself, so you can buy Betanio Martins clothing and apparel and other merchandise using the link on my store. And if you're watching this after February 2024, it should be already working.